We, as human beings, have to hack our brains. They are obsolete. We are obsolete systems, as if we carry the 386-based system in 2019. I remember the first PC I owned. It was in 1892. It was a 486-based system, a state-of-the-art computer then. And I remember how I installed Windows 3.11, which came in 15 3.5 inches floppy disks, 15 disks of 1.44 megabytes each. That hardware is already obsolete, and the software too. Any smartphone today is infinitely more powerful, and only 20 years have passed. We, as a species, as Homo sapiens sapiens, are about 200,000 years old, and we have the same processor, and our software is almost the same. So it is clear that we have to upgrade ourselves to go further, because the technology and our world are evolving at exponential speeds, and we are still thinking and still learning in a linear way. Neuroscientists say that our brain receives in average 400 million bits per second, and our brain only processes 40 out of 400 million. What do we really perceive? A reality that is not real, just a tiny portion of the reality. It is necessary to increase the bandwidth of our human brain, increase our level of empathy, to get to feel what others are feeling, and then create new emotional maps. That's what brain hacking is about. If human beings continue learning and thinking like we do now, with our default power and default software, we are on track to be overtaken by machines and artificial intelligence, that they learn faster, better, and even make better decisions than we do now. We have to work at hacking our brain and learn exponentially, focusing 100% of our power on what we are doing, aiming for maximum peaks of efficiency. Nowadays, these maximum flow moments are being created and being researched by the Flow Genome Project team, for example. Maybe hacking the brain goes about installing filters to activate or deactivate parts of the brain when we want, and depending on what we need to do at this moment. Maybe hacking the brain has to do with seeing more where we could not see right now. It also has to do with finding more patterns where we only were receiving noise so far. We have to hack the brain to not stop being curious, to not stop getting excited about the unknown, to keep feeling pleasure knowing that we don't know. For what? To learn by creating, creating what humans usually create: context, spaces, contents, materials, technologies, creating relationships, creating dreams, and learning our creative energy transport us to the cosmos. In other words, to learn exponentially, to be learners, creators of complex cosmovisions, from the most micro to the most macro, and also creators of connections with other human beings, of course, but with machines or devices or with processes or with data. Complex, powerful, broadband, high quality connections. I believe that we, as human beings, in order to live or survive in this ever-evolving world, which is being transformed and revolutionized at an exponential speed, we have to manage to hack our brains and learn exponentially. Learn exponentially.